Hello everyone, in this video we have one right triangle and this length is given root 3 and here is given 2, angle DAC is given 30 degrees and question is what is the value of x? Okay. First step, let's call here alpha and if you focus on triangle ABC, for this triangle, if we calculate tangent alpha plus 30 degrees, notice that tangent alpha plus 30 degrees equal x plus 2 over root 3, right? Therefore, we know that the expansion of tangent alpha plus 30 equal tangent alpha plus tangent 30 over 1 minus tangent alpha times tangent 30 equal x plus 2 over root 3, right? Okay. If you focus on triangle ABD, for this triangle, tangent alpha equal x over root 3. Moreover, we know that tangent 30 equal 1 over root 3. Therefore, if you plug in this value to the equation, tangent alpha is x over root 3 plus tangent 30 equal 1 over root 3 over 1 minus x over root 3 times 1 over root 3 equal x plus 2 over root 3. So if you organize the equation, x plus 1 over root 3 over 3 minus x over 3 equal x plus 2 over root 3, right? So let's clear here. So x plus 1 over root 3 times 3 over 3 minus x equal x plus 2 over root 3, right? Therefore, these are again. So 3x plus 3 equal 3 minus x times x plus 2. Therefore, 3x plus 3 equal, if we distribute, 3x plus 6 minus x squared minus 2x. Notice that these are again. And if we move these terms left-hand side of the equation, therefore we get x squared plus 2x minus 3 equal 0. X squared equals x times x and minus 3 equals 3 times negative 1. So x plus 3 times x minus 1 equals 0. So x can't be negative. Therefore x equal 1 unit. This was the first method. Now we will calculate value of x using second method. Okay. First step, notice that, let's call here theta. Theta is greater than 90 degrees, right? Therefore, theta is an obtuse angle. Why? Because notice that if here is 90 degrees, angle BAD must be equal 0 degrees. But it's impossible. For example, if angle BAD is equal 1 degrees, that means angle ADB must be equal 89 degrees. That means angle theta is exactly greater than 90 degrees. Right? Okay. Therefore, if you focus on triangle ADC, if you draw circumcircle of this triangle, angle ADC is an obtuse angle. That means center of the circumcircle must be outside of this triangle. Right? So the circle passes through point A, point D, and point C. Let's call here point O, which is center of the circle, and if we connect center point with corners of the triangle, these blue line segments are radius. Next step, if here is 30 degrees, this arc must be equal 60 degrees, right? That means center angle must be equal 60 degrees. Therefore, we get an equilateral triangle. So these are must be equal 60 degrees. After that, if you draw a perpendicular line onto the chord will be divided into two equal parts. So these two parts must be equal 1 unit, right? And these are must be equal 30 degrees. Because of equilateral triangle. Then notice that if there's a 1 unit opposite of the 30 degrees, opposite of the 60 degrees must be equal root 3. After that, if you focus on this quadrilateral, these two lengths are equal and these two angles are 90 degrees, right? If you focus on this quadrilateral, let's call here point K. That means ABKO is a rectangle. Therefore, angle BAO must be equal 90 degrees. That means point A is a tangent point. So we can apply tangent secant theorem. Right? According to tangent secant theorem, square of root 3 equal x times x plus 2. Right? So x squared plus 2x minus 3 equals 0. If you notice that this equation is the same equation as the equation in the first method. So x will be equal 1 unit. Or you can think like this. Notice that if there's a 1 unit opposite of the 30 degrees, opposite of the 90 degrees, here must be equal 2 units, right? Notice that this length is also radius. So x plus 1 must be equal 2 units, right? Therefore, x is going to be 1 unit. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care. and